Now we'll be starting your takeover code and the questions that have been asked. Now in your exam, they have actually asked you a multiple times your enterprise value. Now what is exactly enterprise value and how is it coming under the takeover code? So enterprise value is talking about the value of a company. When I go to purchase it, when I go to acquire it, how much do I need to pay for it to acquire the company? So if I just go it in words form, enterprise value equates the amount that it would cost you to pay every single one. Okay, your shareholders, equity shareholders, your preference shareholders, your outstanding debt. I would have to pay all of them to purchase the company. Yes or no? Only thing, the cash will be subtracted from the to get the enterprise value. Why is cash subtracted? Because that's mine. I don't have to pay it to anybody. So that would help me, because you would have the, once you have acquired the complete ownership of the company, the cash is actually ours. So we subtract it. We don't have to pay it to anybody. Let's understand in simple little words. Ek company mere ko buy karni hai. If I want to buy a company, would I have to pay all the equity shareholders? Yes or no?
Yes.
And I will have to buy them out at the current market price. Yes or no? So whatever is the prevalent market price, I have to buy all of them. Second, there must be certain lenders. I will have to pay them also. Yes or no? The company must be having certain creditors. I will have to pay them. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Even certain other minority shareholders must be there. I will have to pay them also. That I give me this company. I want this business. I am ready to purchase every single one. So I'll pay all the equity shareholders. I'll pay the creditors. I'll pay the preference shareholders as well. Now the company has cash. Let's say the company has cash. Normally the cash is an asset, but do I, this cash what is there that the company is having in the bank account, isn't it good for me? Isn't it good for me that the company, that the target company has cash in its bank account? It is good for the acquirer or no? It is good for the acquirer or no? So let me give you an example. You will understand it better. Let's say I want to acquire. This is my target company. This is my target company. And I am the acquirer. So I find out what is the market price of the equity shareholders. I came to know it is 2 crores. I said 2 crore de denge. Debt kitne ka hai? 1 crore. De 1 crore de denge. Minority shareholders, let's say of 1 crore, they denge. Equity shareholders of 2 crores. Theek hai? Yahan tak. So how much I will have to remove to buy this company, to buy this target company? How much money I have to remove to buy this company? I have to remove 2 plus 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 crores to buy this company. Yes or no? Yes. So this is the enterprise value that I need 6 crores to buy out this entire company. Now when I buy out, I'm going to see that the company, this target company, already has cash with it. It has a cash in its bank account of 1 crore. Now tell me, do I need 6 crores to buy this company? Now I'll require only 5 crores. Now I will require 6 crores or 5 crores only? Because this cash becomes mine, na? This cash becomes mine. So I will use this only. So the enterprise value is actually from the takeover point of view, the acquirer point of view, that this target company, how much it is going to cost me to buy it. So it will cost me 6 crores or 5 crores?
5
crores. Because I'll pay off everyone and whatever cash is there, it's actually mine only. So that will, I'll really use it to pay off all these people only. So it ultimately reduces my purchase cost. So therefore, cash and cash equivalents are subtracted. Is this concept clear? Yeah. Now quickly we'll go through the sums once you know that why cash is subtracted. Because cash तो अपना ही हो जाएगा बाद में, वही use कर दूँ pay off करने के लिए, तो मेरा तो खर्चा कम हो गया ना. अब quickly इसको we'll do the sums. Enterprise value in case of takeover code. Calculate the enterprise value. ठीक है, equity shareholders outstanding 160,000. Now this is equity share capital of this much per share. Now you have to understand one more thing. What is the market price I need to compute? Market price on the closing day is this much. Reserves and surplus is of this much. Minority interest is of this much. Preference shareholders are of this much. Cash and cash equivalents are of this much. And current assets are of this much amount. Now, what am I going to do? I'm going to say what is the market enterprise value. It is a market capitalization. Now, market capitalization, first I have to see. This what is given here is in the balance sheet. Yes or no? The equity share capital is in the balance sheet. Is it reflecting the book value or the market value?
Book value.
This is the book value. Books mein itna mentioned hai. Mere ko market price se multiply karna hai. So first I will require the market price. So market price is 125. Into the total number of shares. Number of shares. I'll come to know the market value. Yes or no? So once I do this, I'll get the market value. So market price into the number of shares. Number of shares kaise dhoondenge? Itna value hai and one share is of 2 rupees. So if I divide this, I will come to know how many equity shareholders are there. So I'll come to know that there are 800 equity shares of rupees 2 each, multiply karke 1600 lakhs ka value. So how much is the number of shares? Can anyone tell me?
800 lakhs.
So the very first thing is you have to compute the market value. From the book value, you divide the number of the par value, the face value. You will come to know the number of shares. Number of shares into the market price will give you the market capitalization. So once this is done, then I require the debt amount. What is the debt? I'll have to pay the debenture holder, the creditors also. It's given? No. No debt in the company? No debt. Zero debt. Then do they have minority shareholders? Yes, minority shareholders. They also have preference shares. And cash and cash equivalents will be subtracted. No other adjustment is needed. Formula is this only. Clear till here? So, I'm buying off all the shares and whoever the owners of the company. So the market share capitalization is 800 lakhs into 125. So this plus all of this minus cash and cash equivalents is your enterprise value. Cash and cash equivalents will be used to subtract it. यही पैसा use कर दूँगा उनको pay off करने के लिए, तो ये minus हो जाएगा. Yes or no?
Yes.
Next, I need the market capitalization. This ये जो है book value है कि market value है?
Book value.
Book value. This divided by this amount will give me the number of shares. Number of shares. This I will multiply with the market price, which will give me the market value. So the market price diya hoga 96. So isse mil jayega, I'll multiply, I'll come to the market value. Then I will have to pay off the minority shareholders. I will have to pay off the short term borrowing. So I'll add up all of these things who I have to pay off and I will use the cash to pay off to the people. Okay. So enterprise value is given. We find out first the market value and then we do the calculation. Clear till here? Now is another type of questions for your SEBI takeover code, that is SEBI substantial acquisition and of shares and takeovers regulation 2011. It's mostly talking about an escrow account. Whenever the acquirer, let's say there is a acquirer, he wants to acquire the target company. Target company को buy out करना है. यहाँ तक clear? अब obviously he wants to buy out. So what happens? There is a merchant banker appointed. Merchant banker is the SEBI person. Okay, he is a intermediary of SEBI who will tell the acquirer to set up a escrow account and to deposit funds in this escrow account to see whether he can honor his paying of responsibility or not. मैं भी जाके बोल दूंगा I'll buy out Mukesh Ambani. In the end, when they tell me to pay, I say I don't dare. So that shouldn't happen. So and also that I take it seriously. They before I make this kind of I proceed further. Certain amount of funds is to be deposited in the escrow account. Is this clear? Yes. अभी देखते कितना क्वांटम है. तो पहले हम लोग को लॉ देखना पड़ेगा. So it says first this is again a legal sum. Once you know the law, then it's very simple. So acquirer must create an escrow account not later than 2 working days prior to the detailed public announcement. So before he gives the detailed public announcement, he has to give a set up an escrow account. Now escrow account mein how much he has to deposit on the first 500 crores. So whatever he's going to buy out the company, we'll come to know what is his offer size, what is his offer price. Accordingly we can compute how much liability aa sakti hai. If I am going to buy out Reliance industry, so someone can compute how much my liability can be. So for the first 500 crores, or I can even go to buy out a small company. So smaller company ka escrow account mein kam figure jayega because usme requirement bhi kam hogi. So for the first 500 crores, I have to deposit 25% consideration. And for the balance consideration, additional 10% has to be given. So let's say if a company is there and I find out that my liability is 200 crores. So I just have to give 25% of 200 crores. But if I come to know it is 700 crores that my liability can be. So the first 500 crores I will give 25% of 500 crores. Or jo excess hai, okay, for the balance consideration. So 700 crores or 200 crores ka 10% meko additionally add karna padega. So dekhte sum mein. ये उसका लॉ है. दिस यू शुड नो. सो व्हेन एवर वी आर डूइंग लीगल सम्स यू विल हैव टू गो बैक टू द चैप्टर, लर्न द चैप्टर, नो द लॉ. हियर इट इज अ सम्स, द प्रैक्टिकल एस्पेक्ट्स. पढ़ लेते हैं. रोमियो इंटरनेशनल लिमिटेड इज लिस्टेड ऑन द बॉम्बे स्टॉक एक्सचेंज. गुड. ऑन फ्राइडे वन ऑफ द शेयर होल्डर्स गणेश, हु इज ऑलरेडी होल्डिंग 30% स्टेक, मेड अ पब्लिक अनाउंसमेंट फॉर ओपन ऑफर फॉर एक्विजिशन ऑफ 13 क्रोर्स equity shares constituting of 26% of the capital of Romeo Limited. So this guy who was holding 30% says, let me, I want to take more additional this much 13 crore shares, and after which he was triggering the open offer. Offer price that he was giving is at 500 rupees. So he's giving 500 people rupees also. Is ready, is an offer to the shareholders of the target company that I'm giving you 500 rupees. How many of you all want to sell? Now let's see what is the question. What is the time limit for depositing? So again we saw not later than 2 working days prior to the detailed public announcement, escrow account has to be created. So very simple. And what amount should be deposited? Again, for 500 crores, up to 500 crores, 25% should be given. For amounts beyond 500 crores, for the first 500 crores, you will give 25%. For the amount beyond 500 crores, you will give 10%. Explain the various forms of maintaining escrow account. So, bahut hi simple, ye to general sum hi tha. Yahan pe hum log dekh rahe consideration payable. Okay, so they are calculating also and they are showing. He wanted to buy additionally 13 crore shares and he is giving 500 crores. So we can compute how much is can be his liability. Yes or no?
Okay.
So 6,500 crores he should have. So now how much he should have in the escrow account? First 500 crores ka 25% and for the balance, that is 6,000 crores, 10%. So adding up, you will get 725 crores. And in the escrow account, do you always have this, acquirer always has to deposit cash? He can even give cash equivalents. Cash he can also give. He can deposit some shares worth. He can pledge his shares, or he can get a bank guarantee. A bank will guarantee that this much amount he will pay. If he doesn't pay, we will pay. So, or a combination of all of them, escrow account can be made in these kind of forms. So, in the escrow account, you can deposit cash, you can get a bank guarantee, or you can deposit shares.